Okay, today I want to talk about the hot topic of the day, and that is healthcare reform, and the debate that's going on in Washington. First, I want to say this, that a year ago, there was absolutely nothing that Republicans could do to stop anything that Democrats wanted to do. They had a filibuster-proof majority in the Senate, had an overwhelming majority in the House of Representatives. So the fact that we are here and they are still trying to pass this healthcare legislation doesn't have anything to do with Republicans roadblocking them. It has to do with the fact that the Democrats haven't been able to agree amongst themselves to pass this legislation, and to blame it on, you know, well, it's the Republicans' fault. That's just not the case. They had an amazing, you know, opportunity to do pretty much whatever they wanted to, and they didn't do it. Here's the problem with the government right now. The government's problem is it thinks that it is the solution to everything. To every problem that a man or woman in this country faces, the government thinks that it is the first, last, and best solution to that problem. And it's not. All right? Let's talk about healthcare. Perhaps the solution isn't a government takeover of the healthcare industry. Perhaps we should think about why it costs so much more to have the same procedure done in this country that to do it in another country under the same conditions, same qualified staff, would be potentially thousands of dollars less. I think we need to look at that. I think we do need to look at regulations. I think we need to make healthcare more affordable. I think we need to make healthcare easier to get for people with pre-existing conditions. I believe all of that. I believe that, you know, that healthcare is not a right, it's a privilege, but I believe that it is something that we as a nation can do to make sure that everybody has the same rights and can get the same healthcare. And if you're rich and you want to have a Cadillac plan, or if you're poor and you're relying on Medicaid or Medicare or something like that, that no matter what end of the spectrum that you're on, you can receive health care and it's not going to bankrupt you or your family or the next generation. But I think it starts, here's the thing. I'm going to go over time today, and that's okay. I want you to think about this. Think about this, okay? Who controls school lunches? Who controls school lunches? Well, that would be the government. Have you seen a school lunch lately? I have had lunch with my kids at their school. And I know that those lunchroom ladies do the best work that they can. I know that they only have so much to work with. But I have found no redeeming qualities in a school lunch. So we have a government, we have a system that from a child starts going to school, we're telling them about the four food groups and the food pyramid and all this stuff, but yet what we give them on their plate, a corn dog, french fries, and a piece of lettuce. But does that really cut it? Does that really cut it? I mean, my girls ask me for ice cream money pretty much every day, and there are some days I relent, but then I'm thinking, why are my kids getting ice cream at school? And so we're raising kids up. I read the other day, was so excited about this, that Pepsi is pulling their machines from schools. That's a good first step. That's a good first step. Because we're raising kids, we're feeding them this junk food, we're wiring their minds and bodies to like the fried, greasy, unhealthy stuff. And then as they grow older and the foods that they're eating are causing health problems, it's making healthcare costs rise. And so the government's like, well, we need to fix this. So I see it's kind of weird that the one who's trying to jump in and correct and solve the problem is partially responsible for the problem. Here's the thing. You're watching this today. The bottom line is this. The government can't save you. Nothing that they do can truly make your life better. And the harsh reality is this. Politicians and government officials and the government, they're not really interested in making your life better. They're only interested in whether or not you're going to vote for them again. I'm going to leave you with this because I think this solves most of our problems. What if politicians couldn't do that for a career? What if there was no such thing as a career politician? And what if a politician was free of having to worry about re-election? That they could be elected to a specified term. No, re-election is not an option. They could vote their conscience. They could, whether I agree with them or not, they could vote their conscience and they could do the right thing for our country without regard with whether or not it was going to get them reelected or not. I think, you know, politicians spend probably 5% of their time actually worrying about our country. And they spend the other 95% trying to raise money, get reelected again. It's just a flawed system. And I think if the founding fathers knew that dudes could be in the Senate for 80 years, 60 years, be in the House of Representatives for who knows how long, they would be appalled by that. Because that's not how they wanted the system to run. Finally, let me put a disclaimer on here. These are my thoughts. These are my views. Most people probably disagree with them. I don't know. I'm just trying to use common sense. I'm just trying to think of what's good for all of us. What do you think? What's your take?